After the round.
By the way, Ryan did an interview yesterday. You guys see it? He said that his legs were gone. He could tell, he said, because he didn't rehydrate well. So he wanted to go for the knockout in the second round because he knew he wasn't all there.
And then he had to couldn't gain so much pounds after this, all that? Of course. If you're putting those...
Tank shouldn't have done that.
Exactly. Tank shouldn't have done that. Tank is doing that, that means, you know...
I don't think Tank is sitting there typing out contracts.
Are he okay?
Well, he just signs it.
If we told Bam, we're going to do this rehydration clause for your opponent. And Bam says, yeah, that's cool. Bam is okay with it.
Do you want the fighter to say, take this out?
Tells us, no, don't do that. She's like, that's stupid. Okay, then we're not going to do it. You know what I mean?
He shouldn't have done it.
Tank was going to beat him either way.
He shouldn't
Tank
have done it.
Tank was going to beat him either way. He shouldn't have done
that. He shouldn't have done that.
He was going to beat him either way.
See, but they also, they're now smart also. Now
draws excuses and stuff.
For a rematch.
Maybe, yeah. There will be a rematch. I know there will be.
They do it, maybe for that reason, yeah.
No, they do it the smart way, so now Ryan has a reason and an excuse to say, they made me lose weight. Oh, that couldn't get so much weight. So they do it on purpose also. It's also part of the business.
So Ryan said they will do a rematch at 140. What do you guys think of Ryan Tank rematch 140?
It'll sell a lot again.
Ryan Tank 140.
It'll sell a lot again.
Tank's a better partner.
Then Ryan said that after the fight that Tank's team treated him better than his own team.
Nah, I don't know.
That's what he was saying.
I don't know. When you hear about how training camp was for Ryan and stuff like that, the interviews Joe Goosen was doing where he was talking about how you don't really train Ryan, you co-train him, you listen to his ideas and stuff like that. It sounds like Ryan wasn't listening to his friends either, so
listen, he has a new coach, new weight class, and it was a fight that broke records.
If it was his trainer's fault, and he thinks Darren, if it was his trainer's fault, then in the rematch, he better fucking tank. If he thinks it was his trainer's fault, or if it was because of the, you know what I mean? If he goes and gets knocked out again, then all that stuff that he was saying about Joe Goosen and all this and that, I think Joe Goosen should have gone up there and, you know, whatever. But the trainer's always the one that's going to take the blame anyway.
But that's the sport. It's always like that.
The trainer's always going to take the blame. Because right now he's with Derek Jenkins. And that's the bad part about it, too, that the trainer always gets, you know, the blame for, you know, for fighters losing. Derek James right now is training two fighters who I think don't fit his style. And it's becoming what we were talking about, how Canelo with Eddie Reynoso with the guys that he's getting. Eddie Reynoso was training. He has Canelo, who's a big star, who he started since he was a kid, done a great job with him. He started getting a lot of fighters that didn't train as hard, that weren't as, you know, talking about Ryan Garcia, that weren't putting in the work the way Canelo was. So Ryan Garcia was going to make Eddie look bad, because even if Eddie would have been training up for this fight, he was going to lose and he was going to get stopped. And then, Eddie couldn't do his job with them. Or fighters that maybe aren't as talented as Canelo or don't have the same style, the similar style and stuff. I think the same thing is going to happen with Derrick James. He has guys and, you know, my dad trained them and stuff. And I've heard, you know, stuff. I mean, I'm not going to get into specifics, but where, you know, Anthony Joshua and Ryan Garcia, where they could potentially lose their next fight, it's not going to be Derrick James' fault. Derrick James, his work is with Errol Spence and with Charlo, with how great. And Frank Martin. Those three fucking dudes are fucking, they're bad motherfuckers. They're not dudes that are soft or that have ever had that stigma around them. So Derrick James could train them the way he wants them to train, where neither one of his guys is a defensive specialist, where they're not getting, you know, he'll push his guys to the way Emmanuel Stewart used to, where let's go for the fucking knockout, let's push it, and you know what I mean? And those three guys have that motor, that heart, that grit, that kind of style that fit Derrick James.
Unified champ,
Ryan Garcia
champ.
And Anthony Joshua do not fit that mold. So if they lose, and the trainer always, Derrick James shouldn't get any of the blame for those guys losing, because his style fits the other three guys, the, you know, Frank Martin, Charlo and Spence. And those are the three guys. Obviously, the money is insane that he's going to make with AJ and with Ryan.
As he should. Why not?
Nobody make your money. Him. But when those guys lose and those guys don't show up the way they should, then they should not be there against that either. That's not his. Those aren't his fault. So now Ryan is saying the stuff that he's saying about, oh, Joe Goosen did this, you know, or there was a move like that. But that's okay. When you go with Derrick James and you fight Tank for the rematch, or you fight whoever, and you lose, he better fucking, you know, better not say the same shit, you know, now it's this trainer's fault. No, now it's a fighter's fault. With AJ, the
but
you know, the same
throughout
thing.
The history of this sport, when a fighter loses, I've never heard a fighter look in the mirror and say, you know what, I messed up. In general, not talking about Ryan, talking about in general. A fighter, Robert, and you know this, will always blame the coach. I don't care who you had in your gym. If they don't win, it's never, it's no, the camp. It's
not always like that, because Canelo, when he lost to Floyd Mayweather, he could have easily said, oh, you know what, I have an inexperienced coach or a young coach and Adrian also and whatever, whatever. He stuck it with
He's
them.
Loyal.
He stuck it with them. There's other fighters that have lost.
You Fernando Vargas with my dad.
There's other fighters that lose, and you just lost, and you stay with your trainer, and, you know, Marquez lost a bunch of times. He never left out the way he's trying. You know what I mean? There's other fighters.
Pacquiao.
Pacquiao lost. He never blamed Freddie Roach. Why lost?
He should have.
No.
I don't think Freddie's...
Like, Fernando lost.
No, there's... You know, you do have guys that do that. But then you have other guys, you know, like...
I would say 90%.
Where he's saying this and that, and it just... Like, for what? Like, you have to look in the mirror and know, you know...
But listen, I wasn't in camp. You weren't in camp, so we don't know.
Yeah, but I've heard about fucking how terrible fucking camp was.
We don't know. I wasn't there. I don't believe what people say.
You hear how terrible it was. It was training. As soon as I saw that he was training, you know, all that stuff, I was like, nope, he's fucking. He's not gonna. I was rooting for him, and you want, right? You know, Ryan. You know, I was rooting for him, and he's asking me, Ryan, and you know, we hope. But
fucking Bear started crying.
So we hear, but you hear about the way camp was and shit like that. Whenever if you. Off camera, if you had asked the parents and when they would ask us who should we bet on, I was telling everybody to put as much money as you can on Tank and bet and Tank's gonna win, this and that. But you just hear about how bad camp was and, you know, that's fucking...
All right, well, let's see what happens next. But I think him and Tank, a massive rematch.
We better see a big fucking... We better see a big improvement.
Him and Rowley.
We're not gonna see that. And then... Who knows how even long he's gonna last with Derek Jane? Because with Derek Jane, he has to be scoring Frank Martin. It's like if he comes in and he has to play Raymond and both of those guys, we'll fucking see how good he's doing. Because the other guys are scoring each other. Spence scores Charlo all the time. So let's see if fucking Ryan can hang fucking scoring Frank Martin and all those guys.
You know who Frank Martin beats right now? Devin Haney. Nah. He said that. I believe him. No, he. You know Frank Martin, he just beat...
But I haven't really paid too much attention.
Very talented.
I know.
Haney called him an old man. He's 28 years old.
Who's old?
He's 28, Frank Martin.
Frank Martin's 28?
Yeah. No, but that's not old. He's undefeated. Ellie Sekback reporting. But ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Sekback reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Sekback reporting.